starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning.
Wrong?
Yes. And now don't get excited or anything when I tell you.
When you tell me what?
Jerry, I've got a baby.
Oh, Pam, darling.
Wait a minute.
Oh, but you don't say it like that.
I don't say what? Like what?
I've got a baby. You say I'm going.
Oh, don't I, though? Well, come here. Look.
Holy smoke.
Hi.
As I said, I've got a baby.
So I see, but when? How? What happened?
Isn't he scrumptious?
Huh? Oh, now, look, Pam, whose baby is this?
Well, I haven't the faintest idea. Right now, I don't care.
But it's got to belong to somebody. Babies don't just happen.
I know. Isn't it too bad?
Now, Pam, will you please tell me what this is all about?
Well, somebody left him here with this note. Please take care of my baby. I'll be back for him later.
Darndest thing I ever heard.
Oh, I think it's the nicest. Someday he may be president.
That's what my mother said about me. Oh, no, you don't. No. It's my only watch.
This is our only baby.
Well, I think we ought to call Wigan, the police, somebody.
The note says they'll be back and wants us to take care of him.
I wish you didn't have such a literal mind.
Maybe that's the mother now. Jerry, don't spoil his fun.
No.
My baby, is he all right, is he?
Of course he is. You're the mother?
Yes. Oh, you must think I'm terrible to leave him like that, but...
Well, it isn't
the
usual.
Oh, I don't blame you, but you see, I was desperate. I had to get him away, and your door was open. He is all right, isn't he?
Of course he is. We were just getting acquainted.
Oh, I'm so glad. I was really worried. We were wondering how we were going to get in touch with...
I will call the police. Operator, give me police headquarters.
So, now when your baby disappeared...
It wasn't our baby.
Well, whose was it?
We don't know.
No, it was just left here.
A likely story. How did it get in?
Well, I must have left the door open, either when I went shopping or when I took the trash and the cans and the bottles.
Bottles?
Now, wait a minute.
Watch your tongue, young man. Let me remind you, we have extreme penalties for people having in their possession babies not belonging to them.
But we've just told you.
Was this baby related to you?
No.
There, you see?
Now, wait a minute. You saw the note the mother left.
Yes, but that could be a well-planned scheme.
I resent that.
Watch it.
Officer, are you going to do something about this, or aren't you?
Young woman, I've had 7 years in the line of duty.
Then do it.
Just don't rush me. Stand back. just looked everywhere, but I couldn't find him. Who is this?
The baby's mother.
Oh, see here, young woman. What is this nonsense about you leaving your baby here?
I was desperate. I had to.
Abandoning child. This is a serious offense.
But she came back for him.
Purely immaterial. That was after the fact.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Young man.
Officer, you've simply got to help me find my baby.
First, I must make my report. You may be subject to arrest. Possibly all three of you.
How about including the baby? He stole my watch.
Now we'll call your pa. Well, he'd be glad to see you. Be right there.
Is it good?
So I says to him, all my life I've been a good husband to you. What do you want? Cadillacs?
Yeah. My old lady's like that, only she'll sell for mink.
Minks, I says to Florence. That's for the birds. So she says, okay, mink like she's a bird. So I says, fly away and don't bother me.
Hey, what's that? Huh?
It's a creep.
It's a baby. What do you think it is?
Well, get him out of here or I'll lose my license.
Take it easy, Sam.
Ah!
What do you mean there ain't no answer? There's gotta be. Hello? Hello?
Well, I guess we just had... Oh. Hey, get a load of this.
Come on, give the kid back his watch. What's the matter with you?
Okay.
Yeah. Here, kid, take it.
Now get him out of here.
Sam, ain't you got no heart?
If I knew you was that kind of a guy, I wouldn't come in here. But look, fellas, I gotta be careful. The cops...
Shame on you, Sam.
Yeah. I'm sorry, fellas, honest.
What do you mean, cops? The kid ain't drunk.
Nope, he ain't ordered nothing. Give him a straight shot of milk.
I ain't got none.
How do you like that?
That kind of a crummy place is this.
Oh, now, wait a minute. I don't get no call for milk.
Give the kid some milk.
I'm going to talk to my union.
Well, like I said, if it hadn't been for that screwy taxi driver, I'd never have lost her.
And I pay you a C note as a private dick. You couldn't catch a raindrop in a cloudburst.
So I go in, but there's a million apartments in the place.
Repeat on the address. I'll come down myself. 24 St. Anne's Place. That's the village. I'm practically there. I promised her once I'd give up gambling. Now I'm going to do it. I'll never take another bet in my whole life. You answer them. If they want bluegrass at the Fifth of Jamaica, give them 6 to 5. I got to find a wife of mine.
Hello? Hello?
See the guy at the end of the bar?
Yeah, I'm looking.
He's gonna cry on his beer.
Yeah, Ray Ball. First time I ever seen it.
I've heard about it, though.
Why, Mr. Maris, you're mad.
You could say that again.
Don't you fall down? Don't you feel anything?
I only feel sad. Now, about the baby.
Yeah, where is he at, and why?
Well, he evaporated. Right out of the phone booth.
The kid don't know how to use a phone. And he hasn't got a dime. Look, if you don't find that kid, I'll get a... I'll get a sledgehammer, and I'm going to...
Now, don't get mad again, Mr. Barrett. I'll go down one side of the street, and you go up another.
Yeah, and I'll meet you in Scotland in the morning.
Scotland? I ain't never been there.
What stamina?
Yeah, you know, I knew a guy once took a drink to steady himself. Sometimes he gets so steady he couldn't move.
Yeah, it was you.
Yeah?
You know all that talk about the baby?
Mm-hmm.
You know what that guy is?
Yeah, a snatcher.
That's serious.
Yeah, it's also a felony.
You know, fellas, I'm just thinking. What could we do with maybe, say, $2,000?
Oh, I'd go to California. There's more dames out there than oranges.
I'd go to Miami. Boy, I know a dog down there runs a beautiful race.
What about your wife?
I forgot about her. So I leave her home on account of we only got one suitcase.
Happy. Before we go anyplace, where do we get the $2,000 to go with?
We follow him.
I'm sure the police will find him.
Why, of course they will.
I should never have done it, even in spite of Harry.
Now, don't worry.
Hey, here it is.
Hey, yes.
Oh, my baby, my baby.
Our baby. Just a minute, young woman. Is this the baby in question? I found him roaming in the street.
Yes, of course he
is. And I found her roaming with him. This young man says he's the father. Is that true?
Well, he was, but not anymore.
That's an injustice, an untruth, defamation of character, and a lie.
Please, may I have my baby?
Not so fast. This child's had a rough time.
Why don't you put him in the bedroom and then you can all talk it over?
Well, that's the first sensible thing I've heard yet. Stay where you are. You too.
Ruthie, listen to me. I wouldn't touch you on a bum steer.
Don't you Ruthie me.
But honey, I want you back at the stable. I miss you and the kids something terrific.
They live in a stable. He thinks she's a horse.
Just racetrack paddock.
Must be a bookie.
I just don't want to talk to you anymore.
I'm making a pitch. Here I am, all alone in the world.
I've only been gone an hour.
No, an hour and a half.
And another thing. I don't want my son to be brought up thinking the racing form is a bestseller.
20-1, I'll never read anything but the Wall Street Journal from now on. Look, honey, this is a situation with great embarrassment. My heart is going like a sprinter in the last eight. I'm perspiring with affection for you.
Are you, Harry? No, I told you before it was the last time and I meant it.
Famous last words.
I wish we could help them. I just don't want to listen to you anymore. Harry, you've told me too many times.
But I love you, honey. You know I do.
She loves him, too. I can see it.
Well, then I must be blind and deaf.
Now, I want to get a few facts from you, too.
Married in Philadelphia, Tuesday, 5:00.
Now, you say you were married in Philadelphia.
Yeah, we just come up from Pimpago. I had 3 mudders. On account it was raining.
What's a mudder?
Such an ignorant question. A mudder is a bangtail who loves to go.
Young man, watch your language.
Yes, ma'am.
As for you, young lady, you're lucky I'm not arresting you. The next time it'll be quite a different story.
I'm sorry, officer. I really am.
Well, I guess you can have the baby.
I'll get him. He's gone!
Gone!
Well, Ken, we made it. Yep. When Chuck Mahoney goes on a job, it gets done. Now Mr. Barrett won't be mad no more. Hey, that's a nice fancy hunk of stuff. If I was back at my old trade, I could take that away from you without you even knowing it. But I see my folly and I change my ways. I give it up like that. You ain't listening. Uh-oh. We gotta do something about you. Now, like I was saying, say you was carrying a wallet in your hip pocket. I'd have it before you could say beans. Well, now we're in business. I saw my sister do this with her kid. Let's see. Over. Fold. Print. Under. Around. Pin. There we are. Now stand up and let me have a gander at you. Not bad. Okay, I'll put your pants on. Here. How about some grub? I'm starved. I'll go in and fix us a couple of hamburgers with onions, pickles, and relish. Just relax. How do you like yours? Medium rare or well done? You don't say nothing.
Leave me alone.
Well, I guess I deserve it. It's all my fault.
It certainly is. You and your gambling and your staying out nights. I just couldn't stand it.
Gambling is a curse worse than profanity. Horses, dice, and cards. I won't even play solitaire.
It's too late. Our baby's gone and we'll never see him again.
That's another item which is on my fault list.
I never should have done it. I must have been out of my mind.
I made you do it, honey, if I just hadn't been so selfish.
No. To take our baby and leave it. No matter how wrong you were.
You're right. I was wrong.
No, it was me.
Hey, look, sweetheart, I've been a handicap all my life. I know when the odds are against me.
Harry Barrett, are you trying to tell me I can't take the blame for my own mistakes?
Then I'll get you 20. I'm the responsible party.
I know perfectly well what you're trying to say. But when something is my fault, I'll take the blame for it.
Now, don't be silly.
Oh, so now I'm being silly.
Yeah, I'd better do something about this.
Oh, I didn't mean that.
Well, then why did you say that?
I only said...
That I was being silly.
I didn't say that.
You did so.
Hey, I never said that.
You did so.
Oh, now, wait a minute.
Hey, your crowd in the entry, stay off the track.
Yes, please mind your own business.
Look, I know you're both upset, and I don't blame you. Now, maybe your wife was a
Do you realize that's the woman who shares my name and bits?
Oh, but I only meant that maybe you were wrong, too.
Well, Harry, are you going to let him talk to you like that?
Indeed, I won't. He's a character that needs some convincing.
Oh! Jerry! How dare you strike my husband?
Hey, now, hold everything. Now, look, suppose you and I had a family fight and some outsider tried to butt in. Wouldn't we gang up against him?
Well, naturally, if we love each other.
Well, sure.
Love each other. Of course, that's what I wanted to find out. Oh, now I'm sure the baby will come back.
Yeah, I wonder who he belongs to.
Look, I give you guys credit for drinks, but not for any brains. Now get out of here and take this kid with you. It's getting late.
Yeah.
It means my license if he's seen in here.
Where are we going? Joe's right. Kid should be sleeping at night.
I wonder what time it is. Quarter past. Nice watch. There's something written on the back. To Jerry North, with love from Pam. This must be the owners of the kid.
Hey, I know this North guy. He lives a couple of houses down the street.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Now you don't. Give the kid back the watch. Come on, let's go. Come on, baby. Come on, take a pretzel. That's it.
Now, before we go in, we must confirm. How much should we ask for?
$10,000.
Say $20,000. We got overhead and operating expenses.
Right. And taxes, too.
Yeah. And then it happens. I'm in the kitchen and I yell out, do you want mustard or piccalilli?
What was that for?
For the hamburgers, Natch.
Hamburgers? For the baby?
Also with onions.
Mahoney. You have reached the wire.
Hold it!
Oh, I'll get it.
Good evening, madam. We are the bearers of important news.
Well, come in.
My words will be welcome quickly. $20,000 to be exact.
We would settle for $10,000.
We'll even arbitrate.
Tell you what we'll do. We'll settle for $500.
$250.
Listen, you two. We've had enough double talk around here already. Cut it out or I'll run you in.
Would you mind telling me what this is all about?
The baby!
Oh, the darling!
A photo finish. Here, took his watch. Give it back.
Hey, that's my watch.
Jerry.
You're all under arrest.
The top.
The end. Good night, everybody.
Good night, all.
Hey, how about a reward?
Anything.
Three beers?
It's a deal.
Thanks for everything.
And me too.
Good night.
What do I do with this?
Mr. and Mrs. North is directed by Ralph Francis Murphy. A John W. Loveston production. Produced by Federal Telefilm. Starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning, featuring Francis DeSale. This has been a film presentation.